So this is the unit 3, lecture 1. We know in a unit 3 there are, so in a unit 3 there are three main topics: magnetic circuit, transformer, especially the single phase two winding transformer, and some portion for the auto transformer and the three phase transformer. So let's just start the topic 1 of this unit based on the magnetic circuits. So we start this. So in a magnetic materials, you know, the magnetic materials are those materials in which a state of magnetization can be induced. Magnetic materials, when magnetized, create a magnetic field in the surrounding. So you can classify all the magnetic materials based on the permeability strength. On the basis of this, magnetic materials can be divided in the five category: paramagnetic, paramagnetic, diamagnetics, ferromagnetic, ferrimagnetic, antiferromagnetics. So all the magnetic materials, the few example of the magnetic materials, those the permeability is high and positive. So these are used for magnetic materials generally: iron, nickel and cobalt. These are the main magnetic substances. Those permeability is high, and this made of attracted by the magnets. What is the magnetic materials? Because the response of a material when subjected to an external magnetic field is the root of the magnetism. The magnetism divided in the categories: paramagnetism, diamagnetism, and the ferromagnetism, antiferromagnetism, like this. So in a magnetism, the spinning electrons in the materials behave like the tiny magnets, and these tiny magnets are aligned in the direction of applied magnetic field, and thereby the material is magnetized. So we discuss more in a types of magnetic materials and so on. Now comes magnetism. Magnetism is a magnetic characteristics which can be magnetized. Magnetism, depending on the material's magnetic susceptibility, its magnitude and sign, it can be classified as the diamagnetism, paramagnetism, and ferromagnetism. Ferromagnetism further divided the two: antiferromagnetism or ferrimagnetism. So diamagnetism, which is very weak, exists only in the presence of an external field. But the paramagnetism, slightly stronger than the dia, when an external field is applied, dipoles line up in the field, resulting in a positive magnetism. However, the dipole do not interact. But the ferromagnetism have a very strong magnetism. Dipoles line up permanently upon approximate application of the external field. The two category: antiferromagnetism dipoles line up but in opposite direction, resulting in zero magnetization. Ferromagnetism similar to antiferromagnetism, but dipoles of varying strength and cannot cancel each other. The diamagnetism, the susceptibility is the negative, very small value, will remain constant. Example, the organic materials, superconducting materials, metal like Bi. Paramagnetism, those susceptibilities are positive and very small. Alkali and the transition metals, rare earth elements, examples hai. Ferromagnetism, those sign is positive, magnitude is large, which is a function of H, magnetic field strength. And those examples are Fe, nickel, cobalt. This is the use generally in the magnetic materials for magnets. Antiferro and ferro, all is a positive. एंटी फेरो हैव द स्मॉल मैग्नेटिक ससेप्टिबिलिटी बट द फेरी मैग्नेटिज्म हैव द लार्ज ससेप्टिबिलिटी. तो स्मॉल एंटी फेरो एग्जाम्पल द साल्ट ऑफ द ट्रांजिशन एलिमेंट मैंगनीज ऑक्साइड एंड फेराइट्स एंड द क्रोमाइड्स आर द एग्जाम्पल्स ऑफ द फेरी. सो दीज आर द मैग्नेटिक. वी यूज सर्टेन टर्म्स इन ए मैग्नेटिक मेटेरियल्स. मैग्नेटिक फोर्स MMF. मैग्नेटिक फोर्स इज ए फोर्स दैट अराइज ड्यू टू इंट्रैक्टिंग मैग्नेटिक फील्ड. मैग्नेटिक फ्लक्स डेंसिटी flux upon area and the flux waver area is a meter square. So flux density is defined as the amount of flux per unit area per square meter. Magnetic field strength, which is H, and if the magnetic field is generated by passing current I through a coil whose length is L and number of turns N, then the magnetic field strength is given by total amount of MMF per unit length. Ni, this is the magnetic force MMF, and L is the length of the conductor. So per unit length of MMF is known as the magnetic field strength. Those unit is ampere turn per meter. Relative permeability, the permeability divided by air permeability. The relative permeability is a pure numerical value, therefore has no unit. Relative permeability, magnetic permeability is defined by this. Mu is the total permeability of a metal and mu naught is the air permeability. So relative permeability defined by using this. Absolute permeability is the mu of metal and absolute permeability of air defined by the 4 pi into 10 k power minus 7 Henry per meter, and the relative permeability is mu r. If you multiply the relative permeability and the free space permeability, then you find absolute permeability. So absolute permeability is mu. So we discussed the analogy between electric and magnetic circuit. In this way, we can compare a magnetic circuit with the electrical circuits. So we want to discuss the analogy. We know that in electrical circuit there is a conductivity, but in a magnetic circuit there is the permeability. So the material, those the conductivity is high, this is the good conductor. This similarly, the permeability is high, then this is the good magnetic materials. Similarly, in electrical circuit, you know the EMF, field intensity. Field intensity, EMF per unit length. In a magnetic circuit is the field intensity. Field intensity is represented by the H, is the total amount of MMF per unit length. In electrical circuit, you know there is a current. Similarly, in a magnetic circuit, the analogy equivalent is the flux. In an electrical circuit, the current density, current per unit area. In a magnetic circuit, the equivalent parameter is the flux density, flux upon area. In an electric circuit, you know you have the value of EMF, which is producing the current. Similarly, in a magnetic circuit, the analogy is the MMF, magnetic motor force, and this is the responsible produces the flux in the magnetic circuit. In an electric circuit, the resistance R, which produces or create the resistance to oppose the flow of current. Similarly, in a magnetic circuit, the reluctance is the property of a magnetic material by which it opposes the flow of flux. The formula for resistance is R equals to L upon mu A, sigma A. Sigma is the conductivity. Similarly, in a magnetic circuit, the reluctance equals to L upon mu A. Mu is the permeability. So the analogy parameters, resistance with the reluctance in a magnetic circuit. conductance the reciprocal of the resistance, similarly the permeance is the reciprocal of the reluctance. We can apply the KVL or KCL in electrical circuit. Similarly, in a magnet circuit, we can also apply the KVL and KCL. So at a particular junction, the total algebraic sum of flux equals to zero. And in a closed circuit, the total algebraic sum of MMF equals to zero. Similarly, in electrical circuits. So this is the analogy between electric and magnetic circuit. Now the magnetization curve. In a magnetic circuits, if H is the magnetic field, this is proportional to the current. The current will increase, then the H will increase. And in a core, the flux induces. In ideal case, if the core is ideal, then the variation of the flux and the H magnetic field strength is the straight. But in practical case, this is the variation. As well as you increase the current or you increase the H magnetic field strength, the magnetic flux start to increase in the core. Initially, the variation of flux is proportional to the variation of current or flux H. But after some time, after start to saturation, and there's a knee point. After the knee point, the saturation comes and completed. The saturation, the flux will not increase further if you increase the value of H. So this is the magnetization curve of a magnetic matrix of a practical BH curve. As the B equals to 5 flux upon area, flux is the MMF upon reluctance. B equals to mu H, by using B equals to mu H, you can draw this curve. H is independent of the core materials and depend only the currents. So if there are the different types of magnetic materials like the cast iron, cast steel and steel. So in a cast steel, the variation is the very small, but in a cast steel, the variation is quite large, and only steel, this is very large magnetization reaches. In this way, you can draw the BH curve for various materials like the cast iron, cast steel or the steels. BH curve. BH curve is very important characteristic for a real magnetic materials in which you can draw the curve between the B magnetic flux density and the H magnetic field strength. So B equals to mu H, by using the relation you can draw this. Now you increase the H in the X direction and the point, or you can measure the value in the flux density B in the Y direction. So if you increase the value of H, you increase the value of current, you will increase the value of H. As soon as you increase the initially, the variation of flux like this. So this variation is initially the flux increase linearly. But after some point, knee point, it will be saturation comes and the flux is not proportional to the current. And in this way, there's a variation and this the saturation comes. After the saturation, the flux will not increase further as you increase the value of current. Now, if you decrease the H magnetic field strength, the flux should be decreased. But the decrease of flux curve is not reverse, but it follows the like this. So this is the reduction of flux in the core, and at this is the point B when the value of H is zero but some flux remain in a core. This flux OB, this flux remain core, which is known as the residual flux. Now we further decrease the value of H in the reverse direction, so the amount of H required to wipe out or to make the maintain the residual flux zero, this is known as the coercive force. The coercive force is the force required to wipe out the residual flux in the core. And after the point C, if you further decrease the value of H or magnetic field strength, the flux will start to increase but in the negative direction. So in the negative direction, flux is again start to increase and reach at the saturation. So this is known as the reverse magnetization. So in the reverse magnetizations, further you increase the value of H in the forward direction. Now H increase like this in the forward direction. So this magnetization flux will decrease. Again, it will not follow in the previous path, but it follow this new path. And point E, you maintain the value of current or H equals to zero, but the sum flux also remain in the core. And this OE again known as the residual flux. If you further increase the value of H in the forward direction, so the amount of MF or H required to wipe out this residual flux OE, again known as the coercive force. And after F, you further increase the value of H, then the magnet flux increase in the forward direction. So this is the forward flux. So in this way, there is a loop. In this way, initially O2 is the magnetization. From A to B, this is the demagnetization. And OB, this is the residual flux. And BC, this is the demagnetizations. And in the reverse direction, magnetization, reverse magnetization is the CD. And reverse demagnetization is the DF. And the forward magnetization is FA. So it comes as one loop. This loop known as the BH characteristic of BH. So the amount of hysteresis loss depend on this BH loop. So due to the repetition, the magnetization or demagnetization process in a magnetic matrix, the losses come. This loss is known as the hysteresis loss, and this hysteresis loss depend on the cross section area of this loop. If the area is less, then hysteresis loss will be. If the area is high, then the hysteresis loss will be high. The inductance can be calculated by using this formula. We know the V equals to N di upon dt equals to N d phi upon dt. So in this way, the Li equals to N phi. So L equals to N phi upon I. So you can calculate the inductance. If you have the number of turns, flux and current. If we know the flux equals to Ni MMF over R, you put the value of phi in this L, so it comes relation N square upon R, where R is the reluctance. So this is the reluctance. So in a magnetic circuit, there are the series circuit in which the flux is flowing through a core, though reluctance is R. So the equivalent circuit is Ni, which is the MMF, which is produced due to the number of turns and the current from one side. And this MMF produces the flux. So where the reluctance of a magnetic material is R, and the drop across the reluctance is H into L. So H or L product give the MMF. So you can say Ni equals to HL. Similarly, this is the other circuit, series circuit. The same case, the one side number of turns produces the, due to the current, produces the flux. And this flux will travel in a magnetic circuit as well as through the air gap. So two media, one is the iron, those reluctance is Ri, and other media is the air gap, those reluctance is Rg. Because the same flux is flowing through the iron media as well as the air gap, so these two media or the corresponding reluctances are in the series. So the reluctances of iron and the reluctances of air gap are connected in the series, and the same flux will flow through this. So this is the equivalent circuit of a magnetic. This is given. The drop across the iron reluctance is can be given by the HI or LI. The HI is the magnetic field strength corresponding to here. LI is the length of the magnetic material in a core except the air gap. Similarly, the drop across air gap is the Hg into Lg, where Lg is the length of the air gap and H is the field strength corresponding to this. So you can write the equation. If you convert equivalent as an electrical circuit like this, you replace Ni with a V or flux as a I. So this the those equation is V equals to IRI plus IRG. Similarly, for a given circuit, if you replace the V equals to Ni and current equal replace the flux, then this is the Ni minus phi RI minus phi RG. So these are equations. Ni is the total ampere turns in the circuits, and this is equal to HILI. This is the ampere turn required for the iron, and HGLG, this is the ampere turn required for the air gap, where the H equals to B upon mu. If the relative permeability is mu R, so B upon mu naught or UI, this is the relative permeability of the air. For Hg, the relative permeability is 1, so only B upon mu naught give the Hg value. In this way, you can solve the circuit. This is the parallel magnetic circuits, in which this is the core, there are three limbs, left side limb, center limb and right side limb, and a number of turn N coil having current I is flowing through this, and this coil producing the MMF. And this MMF from the left hand side limb produces the flux phi. Now this flux phi at the junction Q, there are the two paths. One flux flows in the center limb, other flux phi 2 will flow in the right hand side limb. So the phi total flux equals to the phi 1 plus phi 2, just like the parallel electrical circuits. So the flux is distributing in the two circuit. One circuit is one from Q to T through the M, flux is phi 1, other flux phi 2 from Q to R, S and T. So phi equals to phi 1 plus phi 2. In a parallel circuits, this is the equivalent circuits, where in the left hand side Q, P, U, T, this path represented by a source and the reluctance like this. So Ni, this is the MMF of the coil in the from the left hand side, and this is the reluctance of a path from T, Q, P, Q, this path. After this is the parallel to this is the from Q to T, so there are one from Q to M, the reluctance, other reluctance is from M to W, this is the air gap, and then the W to T, this is the air iron. So in this way, in this pass, there are the three reluctances. One reluctance is from Q to M, other for the air gap, and W to. But the flux phi 1 is flowing same flux through the each media. In the right hand side, the flux phi 2. Those reluctance is Q, R, S, T. This is the path Q, R, S, T. Reluctance is this and the flux is phi 2. So this is the equivalent circuit of a given magnetic circuit. Now in this, just like the electrical, in a parallel circuit the MMF are the same. So this is the corresponding where the reluctance of iron center from QM or WTR combined with the R1. So R1 is the reluctance of the iron and RG is the reluctance of the air gap. So in the center limb, this is the path and this is the parallel of this path. So if you convert this magnetic to equivalent electrical, so this Ni analog is the V, so you replace this, you replace flux with the current I, and the drop across this path left hand side, this is the I into R. In the center, current is suppose the I1. So this is the I1, those drop across iron is I1R1 or I1RG, drop across the reluctance in the through the air gap. So we can write the magnetic circuit equation just like the electrical. So apply the KVL in the clock direction. So V minus IR minus I1R1 minus I1RG. And we know that you can put V equals to I and I equals to phi, I1 equals to phi 1. So this is the equation for a this first loop. In the second loop, you can write the same way. V, this is the path PQRS TUP. PQ, this is the outer path, like this. This path PQRS TU. If you write in this, so this equals to this loop. This is the outer loop. If you write the equation for this, so this equals to V minus IR minus I2R2. This way. You replace V with the N I with the phi, I2 with the phi 2. So this is the voltage magnetic circuit equation. In this way, you can write the equation for a magnetic circuits. So the logic for writing the magnetic circuit is the same as the electric. So this is a question number one. The ring has a diameter of 21 centimeter and cross section area of 10 centimeter square. The ring is made up of two magnetic materials. One is a semi, both are the semi-circular. One is made of the cast iron, other is the cast steel. And there are two joint, each joint have equal to 0.2 millimeter. Now find the total ampere turn required to produce a flux of 8 into 10 key power minus 4 weber in the ring. Given the relative permeability of cast steel and cast iron are 800 and 166 respectively, neglect other effect. So the given is the ring, those diameter is given 21 centimeter, and the ring is made up of two materials, one is the cast iron, other is the cast steel, and the two joint, each joint length is 0.2 millimeter. So the total length of total periphery of this ring is pi into d. D is the diameter. You put 21 centimeter, so you replace it in meter, 10 to the power minus 2, you multiply also. So the total length is this. Out of this two length, this total length, you subtract the joint length, 0.2 millimeter and 0.2 millimeter means 0.4 millimeter. The rest of length is the magnetic material length, which is further divided into two. Half is the cast iron, other half is the cast steel. So given the flux and cross section area 10 cm square, cross section is uniform for the cast iron as well as the cast steel. The given cross section is 10 cm square. First you convert the meter square by multiplying by 10 key power minus 4. So it value come the 10 key power minus 3 meters square. And you know the flux density, which is the flux upon area. So the flux is 8 into 10 to the power minus 4 weber. Area is 10 to the power minus 3 meters square. The flux density, by using this formula, flux upon area, this is the 0.8 weber per meter square. Now for the air gap, the value of H. H is the ratio of B upon mu naught. B is 0.8. Mu naught, because the air gap, the relative permeability is 1. So only you divide by the mu naught. So this value is the value, mu naught is 4 pi into 10 to the power minus 7. The value comes 6.366 into 10 to the power 5 ampere turn per meter. So total air gap length, that this is the 0.4 millimeter. You convert this millimeter into the meter, बाई 10^-3, 10^-2, 10^-3. सो 0.4 इंटू 10^-3, सो दिस वैल्यू कम लाइक दिस इन मीटर. एम्पियर टर्न्स यू मल्टीप्लाई वैल्यू ऑफ एच इंटू एल, दिस इज द टोटल एम्पियर टर्न फॉर दिस एयर गैप्स. सिमिलरली फॉर कास्ट स्टील पाथ, द कास्ट स्टील पाथ द लेंथ इज हाफ पाई डी बाई टू एंड अप्रोक्सीमेट इज द 0.33 मीटर. द वैल्यू ऑफ एच, बिकॉज द रिलेटिव परमिटिविटी फॉर द कास्ट स्टील इज गिवन एज, फॉर द कास्ट स्टील दिस इज 800, सो यू डिवाइडेड बाई 800, सो एच इज द 7.6796 एम्पियर टर्न पर मीटर. लेंथ इज 0.33 मीटर, सो एम्पियर टर्न एच इन टू एल, तो इट्स वैल्यू कम 263 एम्पियर टर्न पर मीटर. सिमिलरली फॉर द रेस्ट ऑफ मैग्नेटिक मेटेरियल कास्ट आयरन, दोज वैल्यू ऑफ एच करस्पॉन्डिंग टू रिलेटिव परमिटिविटी 166 बाय कैलकुलेशंस एच इक्वल्स टू बी अपॉन म्यू कम्स 3835 एम्पियर टर्न पर मीटर. एंड द लेंथ इज 0.33 मीटर अप्रोक्सीमेट. द लेंथ ऑफ कास्ट आयरन एंड कास्ट स्टील आर द सेम. So total ampere turn required, you multiply this value of h and the length, and this is the 1265. Hence the total ampere turn required is ampere turn required for the air gap plus ampere turn required for the cast steel and plus the total ampere turn required for the cast iron. So total value is 1783 ampere turns. Okay.
Thank you.